What's up guys, this is Balazs from Racing Brick. Last year I did a research for you to find an affordable smartphone around $100 that can fully run the different LEGO apps. I use that phone now as a remote for Control Plus and Powered Up. If you did not see that video, then you can click on the link in the top right corner. There's one thing I don't like about the phone, and that's the screen size. It is totally fine for remote control with Control Plus or Brick Controller 2, but it is too small for coding in Powered Up. I have an iPad Air 2 which offers a much bigger screen, but it has a huge disadvantage. It does not provide access to the file system. Why is it necessary? I will tell you in a few minutes. So the aim was to find an affordable Android tablet with decent specifications that is able to run all the LEGO apps. This time Banggood helped me to find a good candidate, so they kindly sent me this Teclast T30 tablet. You can buy it around $200, depending on your region and the actual offers. There's a link in the description with a promo code that will add some extra discount if you order it from Europe. Make sure to check it out if you are looking for an affordable tablet for your LEGO apps. So, this is a 10-inch tablet with a nice Full HD screen, metal housing with matte black finish. It is quite sturdy, there's no bending or cracking, feels very solid. It has a USB-C connector, an audio jack and a slot for the SIM card and the SD card. There's even a connector on the bottom to attach an optional keyboard. Regarding the specs, it has an octa-core CPU, 4GB of RAM and 64GB of ROM, very good battery life and so on. For a detailed review, please click on the link in the top right corner or in the description. I made a tech-focused video about it on my other channel. Oh yes, there's another channel. I used to upload their videos about RC cars, but I decided to give it a new look. I will upload their videos about all the different gear that I use and I like, and you will find some alternative building block manufacturer products as well soon, so make sure to subscribe if you're interested. So let's get back to the tablet and see the properties needed for the LEGO apps. As I mentioned, it has a 10-inch Full HD screen. It is similar to my old iPad Air 2, although the aspect ratio is different. LEGO has several apps with slightly different hardware requirements, but for Android, in general, they ask for 1.5GB of RAM, a 2-core processor, and a screen bigger than 5-inch. For Spy Prime, however, the requirement is a tablet with an 8-inch or bigger screen and 3GB of RAM. As you saw, the memory and CPU parameters of this tablet are more than enough for the LEGO apps based on the specifications. Let's see how it handles them in real life. I added my Huawei P20 Pro, the Xiaomi Redmi 7A and the iPad Air 2 for comparison. Let's see the startup time with the boost app first. That is usually pretty slow to boot. The video was accelerated, but you can see that the three Android devices has a similar boot time and the iPad is a little bit slower. If we compare the controls within the app, it is clearly more comfortable to work on the big screen than on the smaller ones. Unfortunately, there's a noticeable lag using the screen of the Teclast tablet. Based on my tests, it does not affect typing or navigating in the menus, but you need to get used to it when you drag the coding blocks around. The Control Plus app boots quickly. There's not much difference between the devices here. The controls can be used on the big screen as well, and the brightness of the screen is enough to use the controls outdoors under bright sunlight. They are actually more visible in real life than on this video. In the Powered Up app, you can see a similar difference like in the case of the Boost app. The bigger screen makes the coding much more comfortable. Connecting to a hub or multiple hubs works as designed. The Spy Prime app works as well. I will use this tablet for my Spy Prime review that will be coming soon. Despite the decent specifications, the app is not available on my P20 Pro. It is restricted for tablets only. So if you are planning to use Spy Prime on a smart device, then you will definitely need a tablet. So what about that file system access I mentioned at the beginning? Well, in the Android version of the Powered Up app, you can take a sneak peek behind the curtain, as it is possible to reveal the code that runs the different app-specific profiles, and you can even see and test all the internal code blocks. How it is possible exactly? I will show you in a separate video tomorrow. So, to sum it up, I think this tablet is a great choice if you want to use it for coding in the different LEGO apps. With a bigger screen, it is much more comfortable than a smartphone. You get decent specifications for the price. There are some compromises with the screen as it has more lag than usual, but for this purpose I think it is fine. If you are interested in it, then click on the link in the description and please tell me your thoughts in the comments. If you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up. You can also subscribe and tap the notification bell if you don't want to miss my technique reviews and other LEGO RC videos. See you next time, bye bye!